Good afternoon. My name is Daniel Fontaine. I am the CEO and Deputy Minister for Métis Nation British Columbia. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you all here today for a very, very special announcement. I want to first acknowledge that I'm coming to you from the traditional territories of the Coast Salish people, as well as home to the Nova Métis Society. Today is a very exciting day. I'm joined here for this special announcement with Acting President Lisa Smith, also have Minister Patrick Harriet, and our new registrar is Marianne Morrison. They're all joining me here today, and I'll be turning over the microphone to Acting President Smith in a moment to begin the formal part of the program. I just want to say before I do that, beyond thanking you all for being here today, this is a very special moment for me, for our entire staff. We have been working on the Wet'suwet'en project for approximately 6 months behind the scenes. We initiated a lot of what you're going to see today and what's going to be up on the screen started back in the fall in a project to begin a renewal of our central registry and to make sure that it meets the requirements of our citizens, our applicants to become citizens. And you're going to hear some exciting news about that today. And it gives me great pleasure on that note to turn it over to Acting President Lisa Smith for some opening remarks. Over to you.
Thank you so much, Daniel, and welcome everybody. As Daniel said, my name is Lisa Smith. I'm the acting president for Métis Nation BC, and one of my roles is the Minister of Digital Government at MNBC. I want to acknowledge that I'm calling in today from the traditional territory of the Kwantlen First Nations and the home of the Nova Métis Heritage Society. Métis Nation BC is taking big steps forward to update our registration and renewal procedures, and are very excited to officially launch this project. Part of this project involved hiring a new registrar and senior director of community services to lead the registrar team through the 12-month Wet'suwet'en project. It is my pleasure to be the one to introduce you to the new staff person who will be filling that role. Marianne Morrison is a Métis citizen who has come back home to BC after a number of years in Saskatchewan. She brings years of experience and extensive background in leadership and management to the role of Registrar and Senior Director of Community Services. Pardon me. Previously, she worked as the Marketing and Tourism Manager for the Indigenous Tourism Alberta and as Director for the Saskatchewan Indian Gaming Authority. During her time as Director, Marianne developed a provincial digital strategy for the operation of a network of entertainment destinations. Marianne also has an extensive educational background. She's a graduate of the Public Sector Governance Program at the University of Saskatchewan and holds a postgraduate diploma in digital business from the Columbia Business School, MIT. She has also completed an executive development program and holds a management certificate from the University of Nevada. Marianne's connection to British Columbia is through her extended family. Many of them are MNBC citizens, and most live here in BC. So it is my pleasure to introduce you all to Marianne Morrison to say a few words.
Thank you very much, President Smith, for the introduction. It is my honor and privilege to join the team at Métis Nation British Columbia. And as Lisa mentioned, I am a Métis citizen, and I'm really excited to be back in my home province and have the opportunity to serve my nation. There are many opportunities ahead for Central Registry to address the needs of our citizens. Ensuring timely processing of applications and renewals is of utmost importance to MNBC. And it's also important that MNBC citizens are provided with excellent customer service, which is part of my vision and goal that I'll be implementing and improving upon in my role as Registrar and Senior Director for Community Services. I'm very excited about all of these changes, and I'm very honored to have the opportunity, and I look forward to meeting more of the MNBC citizens in my role. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Marianne, for that. I do appreciate those comments and very much look forward to working with you over the months and years to come as we undertake the registry renewal process. At this stage, for the big reveal, we're going to turn it over now to Minister Patrick Harriet, Minister of Citizenship and Community Services, and he's going to take it away and he's going to pull the curtain back and we're going to have a great reveal. Over to you, Minister.
Thank you, CEO Fontaine. Hi, I'm Patrick Harriott, MNBC's Minister of Citizenship and Community Services and Director for Region 1. It's my honor to speak with you today from the traditional territory of the Wassanic people, which is where Métis Nation of Greater Victoria calls home. It is my pleasure to be here with you to announce the launch of Wakotoin, a historic $1.1 million investment in renewing our registry. Time delays in processing citizenship cards, both from new citizens and renewals, was a persistent issue that I heard during my time as a chartered community president. When I first became Minister for Citizenship and Community Services this past fall, I knew improving our service standards, meeting the needs of our citizens, and processing applications in a timely manner was of paramount importance. I'm proud of the work we have done collectively as a cabinet to come to agreement in this investment. Wakotoin will help bring our citizen registry online and address the extensive backlog of citizenship applications. It will provide an all-around smoother experience for current and future MNBC citizens. The $1.1 million investment includes the purchasing of a new registry database, which will provide the ability to auto-generate renewals. It will speed up processing time and allow for the confidential transfer of family documentation to complete files, connecting family members in the new database. It also includes a renewed commitment from MNBC to the registry staff and the entire registry team. With the hiring of Marianne as our new senior director, I'm confident in her leadership in building an expanded team that will include registry support personnel, regional liaison staff, and for the first time ever, a citizenship recruitment coordinator. This coordinator's job will be to assist new citizens with their applications, promote the benefits of citizenship to the thousands of Métis in our province, and bring more of our people home to our nation. Among the immediate actions of Wakotoin is the ability for citizens to address their, or to change their address online. We've heard loud and clear from our citizens that these simple processes should be no more difficult than with any other form of identification, which is why I'm proud to announce that as of today, you can go to mnbc.ca and change your address online. Lastly, and most excitingly, MNBC is launching a new redesigned citizenship card that includes Métis cultural components, which will be launched later this spring. As you can see, the new card is modern and includes enhanced security features, unlike anything MNBC has seen before, while at the same time paying homage to our culture and heritage. I'd like to say thank you for joining us today. I look forward to sharing more good news about the Wakotoin in the weeks and months to come. Thank you, Marcy.
Thank you very much, Minister Harriott. And perhaps I might just take a couple of moments before we conclude our Facebook Live event today and just talk a little bit more, as Minister indicated, about some of the technical components of the new card. I've had a chance to obviously see the design. It looks wonderful. It's taken a number of weeks and months actually behind the scenes to get this complete. One of the nice features of the new card will be the fact that if you are moving within a particular region, you no longer are required to contact MNBC and to get a new card issued to you, because the address is no longer imprinted on the card itself. We will have a record of it within our own database. We've heard loud and clear that the processing and the times and the delays, administrative burden around that, is something we should be dealing with, and this new card does have that. So that's fantastic. The card as well, we will be notifying all government offices, elections, British Columbia. We're going to be notifying the airlines and providing them with new information around the new design so that they have that information on file so that the card can continue to be used as a piece of identification for Métis people across British Columbia. So on that note, I want to thank you very much for coming. We very much look forward to putting these cards into circulation very soon. And thank you very much, Acting President Smith and Minister Harriott, as well as Marianne, for joining me today for this exciting announcement. And thanks so much for being here. All the best.